Well, hello everyone, it's Chef Jazzy John. We are back once again on this lovely afternoon. So today we're gonna travel down a completely different street today. We'll be doing a vegan dish. We'll be doing a vegan black bean burger. It is so delicious. My first experience with a black bean burger is I had catered a picnic and they asked for some type of vegan burger. So I bought some and grilled them. They were absolutely wonderful. So I'm excited. Let's get right into this. So get your pencils and papers ready and we're gonna go down our ingredient list. So first of all, we have 1 tablespoon of flaxseed meal plus 3 tablespoons of water. This is the flaxseed meal. We have 1 tablespoon of olive oil. We have 1/2 of a red onion diced. We have 2 tablespoons of minced garlic. I basically use 1 carrot, which came out to about 1 cup of shredded carrots that I actually shredded. I'll show you that. Then we have 1 can of black beans, which is a 15-ounce can. We have 1/3 of a cup of oat flour. And then we have, for our next set of ingredients, we have 1 teaspoon of cumin. We have 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. We have 1 teaspoon of chili powder. And we have 1/2 teaspoon of paprika. And then we have 1/2 teaspoon of salt, which you know your flavor to your taste buds. And I have some fresh ground pepper. So let's get started. So first thing we're gonna do is dice these red tomatoes. Red onions. We're gonna dice the red onions. I kinda started to dice them already. This is what's gonna give your burger such great flavor and some texture. So you wanna dice it pretty fine. I use a cleaver. If you just don't have a cleaver available, a knife will work. It may take a little bit longer, but the cleaver will work just fine. Okay, so those are ready. So then, if you're one of my regular viewers, you know that I'm allergic to garlic, so I always buy the minced garlic already prepared. So I use 2 tablespoons. And then what I did, I took 1 carrot, and this is the shredder. Hope everyone has a shredder, or you can go purchase one. So this is what they look like when they're finished. But this is what you do. You just take your carrot, and you wash your carrot first. You just rub it down your shredder. Just like that. They do have some smaller shredders. I know mine's a little large. So you have perfectly shredded carrots. So I'm gonna just pour this all in here together. So make sure you can see it very, very well. Move my, discard my other carrot. So now you can see a nice group of shredded carrots. Okay, so then we have, so now we're gonna go to the stove because these are our first ingredients. Well, let's even back up 1 step because our first step is to mix the 1 tablespoon of flax meal with the three tablespoons of water because we're gonna put this in the refrigerator for about 5 minutes. So we're gonna just take that and whisk this together. This is one of your binders. Okay, so we're gonna just take that, put it right in the fridge. I'm gonna actually get my stove started. Okay, so we're gonna just put this right in the fridge for about 5 minutes. Okay, it's 842 to 847. So now we're gonna go to the stove. So now we're at the stove. I have my skillet heating up. So I'm gonna pour in my 1 tablespoon of olive oil. I know some of my viewers have said they like seeing my whole face, but sometimes it's more important that you see what I'm doing rather than seeing me. So that's my 1 tablespoon of olive oil. And I'm gonna bring over the red onions. I'm gonna put them right in the skillet. The red onions. Carrots. Turn this up a little bit more. The carrots and the fresh garlic. So we're gonna get all those cooking. And And so we're gonna cook this about 5 minutes until the onions are translucent or softened. So just stir all this around. So this is basically your foundation for your burger. Okay, so we're gonna let that simmer for about 5-10 minutes. Okay, so now we're at the stove. Our garlic, red onions, and carrots. It's cooking really, really well. It's softened up. You wanna make sure that they're not still tasting firm. So it's been about 5 minutes. I'm gonna give them a couple more minutes. Just make sure everything is nice and soft, so they will come together really great. So in the meantime, I'm gonna take out my flax meal out of the refrigerator. Been in there for 5 minutes or so. So I have this prepared. Okay, so now our next step is, I've actually been doing a couple other veggie vegan dishes. The other day I actually found some chickpea spaghetti noodles, pasta. And I used some vegetable broth and some fresh garlic and cooked the pasta in that. Oh my God, it was so great. And it wasn't necessarily for a vegan, but just a vegetarian meal. A couple of my clients that are on strict diets. And so I use just a little bit of Parmesan cheese just to give it a little flavor. Okay, so this is ready. So now we're gonna be putting this in a nice bowl. Make sure you can see. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we're gonna put all this in a bowl. To the counter, but we can actually do it right here. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna add all of our other ingredients, our chili powder, our paprika, our cumin, our salt and pepper, our salt, our garlic powder, our cumin. Okay, and let me add my and a little fresh ground black pepper. I love fresh ground black pepper. When I first bought it, I used it on everything. So now we're gonna take it and we're gonna stir all that together. So that's gonna start to give you your flavor. So now we'll be moving back to the counter. And you, at this point, you need your food processor because now we're gonna add in the black beans. Okay, so this is just be sitting, soaking, getting that great flavor. So let me reposition the camera. So now we're back at the counter. So at this point, we're gonna take our can of black beans, and with the black beans, make sure you remember I said rinse them and let them drain really well. So I'm just gonna put them all in my food processor, unless you have a high speed blender. So at this point, we're gonna cut them, we're gonna process them, but you do wanna leave some texture, some whole beans in there if possible. So this is gonna be a little loud. And also at this time, you can get a nice platter or something out because we'll, after you make the burger, the patties, you're gonna wrap them in plastic and put them in the refrigerator for about 30 minutes to let them sit and form. Okay, so let's hit the food processor. It maybe one or two more times. Okay. So now we'll be adding the black beans, the blended black beans. That's a tongue twister, huh? So we're gonna add this to the rest of the ingredients that we've already prepared. And as you see, we have a few whole beans sitting there, but most of it is processed. So we're gonna put this in here. Absolutely love doing new dishes. I try to invent new dishes sometime. Most of the time they come out really good because I'm only gonna use things that make sense to me. Okay, so now that's done. So now is the time that you add in your oat flour, your third cup of oat flour, and your, oh my God, I forgot. Your flax seed meal. Okay. So we're gonna put all this in here together. Okay. So now we're gonna stir this up really well. At this point, you can taste it. If you wanna add some more seasoning to it, some more salt and pepper, or if you wanna make them spicy, you know, always say you could add some spice to it if you like to, whatever you wanna do. So also when after I'm done, I have some vegan cheese, some vegan mayo. I found some gluten-free buns, hamburger buns. It's gonna be wonderful. I'm gonna slice some red onions, fresh red onions. I might even saute them. And some cheese, vegan cheese. And we're gonna have some nice burgers. Okay. Let me get another little spatula right here. So this is the time that your hands will probably get a little dirty. This. So now it's all mixed together. So we're gonna form four burgers, four patties with this. Put it right on this little tray. I'm gonna actually just kind of go in myself with my hands a little bit. Okay, so. They're gonna be some nice sized burgers. You want to make them Whoppers, you can. If you want to make them White Castle size, you can. Okay, there's one. They have a nice texture. They're firm. And boy, are they flavorful. Oh, one thing I forgot is to taste it. Okay, that's perfect. Mmm, that is so good. So basically, you eat this like this because it's all vegetables anyway. That's one thing about vegan products. I have a sister-in-law that's vegan. And she had a serious health condition. And she took this route and she is doing miraculously well. So she, when she comes to visit us, she always makes us some nice vegan dishes. Okay, that's burger number two. I'm gonna make sure that they're nice and even and smooth. Okay, so that's burger number two. Okay. We have one, two more to go. Get a little bit more. I should have had me a bowl of water sitting over here, but I'm gonna finish all the burgers first, then wash my hands. These are gonna be so good. If it was summertime, I would actually throw these on the grill. I did have an indoor grill, but it broke, so I have to buy me a new one. And I'm actually even thinking about while we're letting this sit, I may actually do some air fryer French fries so we would have a complete nice burger meal. Okay, so this is the last one. And they are so nice and firm, they're holding together great. My wife is not a big fan of veggie items, vegan items, but watch, she's gonna love this because this has everything that she likes in it. Okay, there we go. So I'm gonna make them a little bit thinner. There we go. Okay, now let me wash my hands. Okay, so I have my plastic wrap. So here's the burgers. They look fantastic. Make sure you guys can see it. So this, you're gonna put the plastic wrap on. And you could actually just put them on a plate or something if you like. I just had these fancy little trays. There we go. Okay. Now we just get it to just go out here really nice and evenly. Well, my sister-in-law is gonna be so proud of me. I can't wait to send her this video. Okay, there we go. Okay. Whoops. Alrighty. So now these will go in the refrigerator, let them cool for about 30 minutes. So while they're cooling off and doing their thing in the refrigerator, I'm gonna get all the other sides together. So I'll see you in about 30 minutes. Okay, it's been 30 minutes. As you see, I have my stove hot. So we're gonna, I sprayed my pan with olive oil spray, cooking spray. I just took the burgers out of the refrigerator. They've been in it for about 30 minutes. So now we're gonna cook them on medium high heat. We're gonna cook them about 5 minutes per side. As you see, the burgers are looking great. They're nice and firm. They are ready for the skillet. Oh yeah, perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay, so my oil is hot. We're gonna just drop them right in. I'm gonna just make sure that they're nice and round. So in the meantime, I've got my tray set up with all of my condiments. I've decided to do some air fryer French fries. I'm gonna call my neighbors over and we're gonna have us a nice little picnic, indoor picnic. So about 5 minutes. So you see they're cooking great. They look perfect. They're so tasty. They're healthy. And I just wanna let you guys know that all the ingredients I used, I was able to purchase them at just my local grocery store. I had to go to the health food store. I actually did a little research. I Googled. So most of your ketchups, mustards, I didn't check on relish, but most of those are vegan. And of course your lettuce, tomato, onions, pickles, all that stuff is natural. So of course that's definitely vegan. I'm so excited about these burgers. I'll be adding this to my menu list. That's what I've been telling you guys. It's been such a blessing to me to cook all these dishes because it's made me grow myself. It extended my research and my wanting to cook even larger varieties of dishes. And you know, people get a lot healthier. Because this is something that, like I said, you can put in a skillet. You can cook it on the grill. Let them cook about 5 minutes on each side. So I'm watching my clock, it's only been about 2 minutes. They're smelling wonderful. I'm gonna turn up the heat just a little bit more. I have all of my products, all of my condiments sitting out ready to go. I'm so excited. Okay, we are back. The burgers are completed. They came out wonderful. I've decided to set up a nice little snack tray. I'm gonna invite my neighbors over so we can have some burgers and fries. So I hope you guys can see everything. This is the, I'm gonna lift this up a little bit for you. Oh, there we go. Messed up my little spoons. Okay, there we go. So there's the burgers. They actually look like they were grilled. Dark.